Oh, there we go.
Ready? On, na?
Ah, one okay, second. They're coming on. Man. Okay.
Okay, terribly sorry about that. Something was wrong with my camera, so my son has taken his iPad and is shooting on that. Okay, we come back to the painting. As I was telling you, as I showed you the reference material that I have, which is a seagull, and I have done the background to a certain extent. And I'm going to give one more coat of the blue to give it some water effect. Okay, now I've done a pencil drawing which is as close as possible to the reference material, and I've done the background. I've taken cobalt blue for the sky and Prussian blue for the water area, and that is the rock which I'm going to be painting with burnt sienna and Prussian blue. I'm not going to be using black, I'm going to be using burnt sienna and Prussian blue. And I'm going to be doing the rock with burnt sienna and Prussian blue. The paper has a good texture, so we use the texture. We use the side of the brush. I usually draw like that. I use the side of the brush to get the texture. Okay, now I go to the bird. I try to avoid black as much as possible, because black, if it is mixed to other colors, it can very easily become dirty. The colors will become dirty and the painting won't look fresh. So I try to avoid black as much as possible. Sometimes you have to use black. But if you're going to be using black, let it be the last color in that area. Don't apply any other color if you're going to be using black in a certain area. Let that be the last color. I'm taking a very fine brush to do the detailed work. If you notice, I'm leaving all the white areas. I'm not painting white, but I'm using the paper white to get my white. And I'm painting the light areas first and then I go for the darker areas. Due to shortage of time, I am just doing a very hasty and rough work. But this is the basic method. You apply a lighter color over darker color, and you have your drawing right. You try to follow your drawing as much as possible. Sometimes you'll have to make slight modifications in areas, but you try to do rendering as close as possible to the original drawing that you have. Hi people, I hope that you have some questions and you're getting ready with your questions. As soon as this is over, we'll go to the question and answer session. We will talk about watercolor, we'll talk about art in general. Then I will have duration.
30 minutes.
Hmm? 30 minutes, huh?
About 30 minutes.
Okay. Okay. I'm just going to leave this here, and we'll go into question and answer, Shashwin. You can go to my Facebook page if you want to see more of my work, and Hindustan Traders shop also has some of my works, you can see that. I'm just going to sign it off now.
Okay, we have a question.
Yeah. Yeah.
What method works best for clouds and sky painting? Wet and wet or wet and dry? And some tips.
Wet on wet works very well. As you saw, this area that I painted was wet on wet. So if you want to show fluffy clouds, you wet the paper, you leave the white areas and paint the rest of the area with cobalt blue. Let cobalt blue slowly seep into the white areas. Do not control the movement. Most of the watercolor painted areas will have accidental effects. You should see what happens and use those accidents to get the effect that you want. Wet on wet is very good for the cloud and sky. After the first layer has been laid, you will have a general idea of what the clouds are going to look like. Then you can have a very light wash on wet on dry. Okay, that would be the best thing to do.
Okay. What kind of pictures can we use for reference? What if I want to take an inspiration from a painting?
Well, let me answer the second part first. If you are going to be taking inspiration from paintings, try to take inspiration from masters' paintings. Don't take inspiration from ordinary greeting cards. There are some greeting cards which are excellent, but try to avoid that. If you are going to be doing watercolor masters, Winslow, Homer, Sargent, and Arul Raj, Pal Raj, Manoharan is there, Sivabalan, Ilayaraja. I'm considered to be a good teacher. No, that's what we call as a master. No? So, see, what I mean is, ours is following a system. So, if you're following a system, your painting is going to be systematically developing. Okay, so look for very good paintings approved by senior painters. If you're going to be looking for inspiration in photographs, they better be yours, or you get the permission of the people from whom you're taking this inspiration. At least give them credit when you're going to be exhibiting or when you're going to be publishing it. Try to take the simplest first as inspiration. Try to learn the interpretation techniques and then go in for complicated inspirations.
Okay. Last question.
Yeah.
How do you smoothly blend or let the color spread on the wet area?
Do you smoothly blend?
Smoothly blend or let the color spread on the wet area. Do you wash initial layer with plain water?
Okay. Wet on wet, you have your drawing intact and you plan. This is the area that I'm going to be covering first, wet on wet. Switch off your fan. If the fan is going to be on, it's going to be very difficult for you to handle the dry and wet area. Though it has been wet, the paper has been wet initially, it keeps drying in the corners. So switch off the fan. Plan what color you're going to lay you should have that wash, we call that wash. The diluted color should be ready. You can't wet the paper and then go start diluting the paint. So you have wet the paper, take the color and start applying. Blending, you have to practice. If you are going to be blending, say, cobalt blue and sap green, that's not going to be very difficult. You know, like both of them are family colors. But if you are going to be mixing cobalt blue and orange, then you have to practice. It blends, but the colors become dirty because they are complementary colors. Practice. And also watch when your seniors who do good work, when they are working in front of you, watch how they hold the brush. And if you have a doubt, you can ask them like how they did this after the work is done, as we do now. You know?
Rouge Rain asks, what is the difference between watercolor and gouache?
Gouache is opaque. As I told you, this is transparent watercolor. See, if you can come, okay. This is a dark color. Still, there can be a darker color. Do you understand? So, this is still transparent. So, we call this transparent watercolor. In other words, watercolor is generally known as a transparent medium. Whereas poster colors, where the pigments are thick, if you have one color or a drawing in some place and you apply gouache, the underlayer is completely hidden. So tempera, poster color, gouache all fall into one category.
What are the prospects for folks doing art nowadays?
If you learn your trade well, as with any profession, if you learn your trade well, and if you keep practicing, if you keep updating yourself, and you should be meeting people of the same kind, birds of a feather flock together. The reason is, it's easier to live that way. If you keep that in mind, well, I'm 70 years old, I'm still in demand. So, you have a fantastic future if your talent is good and if you have the right attitude. And try to make the right connections. Okay, thank you very much. Thank you very much. Let's see if we can meet again. Bye.
And